You know, when Shantiniketan was built, I'm talking of pre-independence, Rabindranath Tagore was very, very lucky to have a rich father. But when he built this, he used to actually make paintings because his brother was an ICS in Ahmedabad, Gujarat. He used to come to Ahmedabad, make paintings, sell them to the rich mill owners, use the money for Shantiniketan, number one. Number two, Shantiniketan was a concept of education. I think that is very important, and all of us architects are supposed to come up with a concept which is unique, which is a marriage of modern and vernacular.
The specimens of 19th and 20th century, where we are just beginning to build as a new country, as a newly independent nation trying to find a voice. However fledgling the voice is, we are trying to experiment. And those experiments, including Charles Courier Stadium in Ahmedabad and various other buildings, IIM Ahmedabad's early, the dormitories that are under threat, all of those represent a certain mode of thinking. And if we don't respect that, we're going to be constantly stuck in this debate of past versus present and Haveli versus glass. That's not the point at all. That just helps us speed up the demolition of everything we have, while actually all that we have is the greenest building today. We need to be able to conserve more. So this is a kind of a trap. We need to free ourselves, and we need to think about all kinds of past, including recent past, for all kinds of people, including ordinary people.
When we say Chandigarh is a modern city, ma'am, उस पर वर्नाक्युलर क्या नहीं है? हम ब्रिक्स यूज़ करते हैं, वही जूट के दरवाजे अभी भी हैं. दोज फोर फॉरनर्स टॉट अस अवर ओन कल्चर. इट्स कॉल्ड द मॉडर्न सिटी. वॉट इज नॉट वर्नाक्युलर देयर? एवरीथिंग इट इज, एवरीथिंग इज नेचुरल, एंड वी स्टिल डू दैट. आई मीन पीपल इन जयपुर और राजस्थान कैन मे वॉयलेट, वी स्टिल डोंट. इट्स अ लॉ that all the public buildings have to be in brick.
Client ne bola sahab mereko ek naya building banana hai, to ek idea aaya dimag mein. Kuch buildings toot rahi thi jo heritage building thi, purane jharokhe the jisme purane unke doors wagera sab around 300 400 years ago purani buildings. Unka isko waste nahi jana chahiye, hum isko use karenge hamari nayi building ke andar. Unko ek proposal diya, ek sketch bana ke dikhaya, unko kafi pasand aaya. Us project pe hum log abhi work kar rahe hain.
We have never said any ism. See, the world had all kinds of names. Bauhaus architecture, we have got, the Baroque architecture, we have got all kinds. India, as usual, we never believed in documentation. We never believed in formalizing. Always everything was very, very informal. And therefore, we never gave names. So, as she rightly pointed out, all these beautiful housing colonies which were talking of ways of mass living from the villages to the cities never got any recognition. The first thing is, let me talk of modern vernacular. There are very two important words. Point is, they cannot be verses. There is some connection. So the whole exploration in today's discussion would be, what is a connect? Ek cheez to maanni padegi, that we are all talking of the same old things, you know. But before doing all that, we have these four very beautiful and wonderful people on the stage with us. Nirottam ji, Amar ji, Sangeet, and Maulshree Joshi, the beautiful black sari. So the first thing I would say is, let's understand who are these personalities here, done by themselves. And I would request you to talk of something while introducing yourself that would talk of modern and architecture as something.
Mera naam Maulshree Joshi hai, main Delhi se hu, and I represent a studio called Space Matters. We are based in Delhi. We are not a young firm anymore. Been around for about 20 years, and I have two other partners, but we are one of the few firms with two women on top, and the third one also happens to be my husband now. So we are three of us. We have a very mixed portfolio.
So that's all. I'm very happy to be here in Rajasthan. Thank you.
Myself, Amar Singh Gehlot, Jodhpur से. मेरी दो फॉर्म है, Swasti Creations और Hariom Infratech. जैसा मैम ने बोला, हम लोग कभी यंग हैं इस फील्ड में, तो आर्किटेक्चर, इंटीरियर, लैंडस्केपिंग, ये सारा काम करते हैं. अभी रिसेंटली हम लोगों ने सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट के जो रेलवे के ABBS के प्रोजेक्ट चल रहे हैं, अभी रेलवे के जो भी स्टेशन हैं उनको रिनोवेशन का काम चल रहा है, उसमें भी मैं अभी 5 स्टेशन कर रहा हूँ नॉर्थ वेस्टर्न रेलवेज के. कंजर्वेशन के भी प्रोजेक्ट्स हैं अपने पास में. गोल्डन टेम्पल जो अमृतसर में, उसको भी हम लोग अभी मेन ड्योड़ी पे हम काम कर रहे हैं, कोशिश कर रहे हैं कि किस तरीके से उसको कंजर्व करा जाए. हेरिटेज प्रॉपर्टीज़ के ऊपर भी ये पर्टिकुलर मेरा इंटरेस्ट ज़्यादा रहता है कि उसको कैसे कंजर्व करें, रिनोवेट करें, या नई प्रॉपर्टी बनानी, उसमें भी पर्टिकुलर स्टोन आर्किटेक्चर को लेकर काम कर रहे हैं. थैंक यू. नेक्स्ट नोस.
हेलो, माई सेल्फ निरोत्तम सिंह. आई एम फ्रॉम कोटा एंड चेयरमैन ऑफ IEI कोटा सब सेंटर. We are doing projects like residential, heritage buildings and institutional projects and somehow interior projects also.
I'm Sangeet Sharma. I come from a modern city. I'm going to talk about vernacular. It's great to be here and I think the topic is invigorating and ma'am is going to take us through. It's going to be very nice. Thank you.
Thanks for the organizers to have this event. And I would like to talk of something fairly stupid actually. You know why I call it stupid? It's all about the kind of time one gives to a project which makes a project. In the vernacular times, or when in the times when people had all the time in the world ki hum ghar kaise banayenge, they thought of hawa kahan se aayega, hum building ko kahan rakhenge, and it was a basic requirement and everything was very informal. So this transition from informal to formal and suddenly becoming a professional thing, I think is the biggest difference between vernacular and modern. So somewhere down the line, the ghar became a designer ghar and therefore came in a whole lot of layers into it. A whole lot of layers that was suited to the time and era it was built. And that gradually layered, got layered, and today we have this modern architecture or whatever. Now, modern architecture cannot be one term. So har ek pal mein jo ghar hua tha, उस जमाने के लिए वो मॉडर्न था, राइट? उस समय जब स्टोन की जाली बनती थी, दैट टाइम इट वॉज मॉडर्न. वेन देर वर नो आर्किटेक्ट्स इन द विजयनगर किंगडम्स, द स्टोन कार्वर्स डिड इन आयोले टेम्पल. ऑल ऑफ अस स्टडीड आर्किटेक्चर एंड इन आयोले टेम्पल देर आर स्मॉल मॉडल्स ऑफ स्मॉल टेम्पल्स दैट वेर ट्राइड एंड टेस्टेड बिफोर दे बिल्ट द रियल टेम्पल. सो दैट वॉज दैट टाइम का मॉडर्न. दे वर वेरी फ्यूचरिस्टिक. द आर्किटेक्ट्स नेम वॉज रिटन. Then came the temple architecture and so on and so forth, and all kinds of fabulous buildings got built depending upon the resources that was available at that time and how it happened. So all that actually was vernacular at that time. Ab us zamane ke modern aur aaj ke modern mein kya difference hai? I think that is what we need to understand before we jump into this major way of classification ki hai kya modern. Now, five elements: light, ventilation, human centric, comfort and proportion. I think that is what makes a building which was meant for a particular use at that time, and today's usages have changed. There were no computers, so there were no tables, writing was less, kisi mein bhi likhte the. Then comes the 20th century architecture, post independence India, which Maulashree is going to talk about, is another style of architecture where the modernism was had a different meaning. Yes, and then we have recycling of a whole lot of old buildings that are getting naturally broken, building materials that are available, and those, how are we reusing them as a part of our responsibility, will be spoken by one of us. And then in an urban setting, why are we always following a fashion and not a conscience? A conscience is always going to tell you what I need in a room. We have vastu, you put it a vastu angle, you put the sun angle, you put the wind angle, it all gels down to one thing, that it's comfort of the user and the human being, right? So that would be addressed by Sangeet. And then we have the big factor of lifestyle. What was the lifestyle then and what's the lifestyle today? How many cars one is having, what's the size of the car, what is the proportion, and all of that. So all these things, and then the water, how can we forget water? Water, culture, and of course the whole perspective of living, you know, why do we live today, how do we live today, you know, hum kitna parties karte hain, all these are a part of modern lifestyle which dictates today's architectural standard. So it's a very complex thing. Ek sentence mein nahi bola jayega ki what is modern and what is vernacular and what is a relationship. So the first question I will tell Maulishree, because we have heard of a lot of natural material, let's focus on the 20th century architecture of India post-independence. I'm talking of Lutyens a little bit, then I'm talking of Indian IIC, then I'm talking of the stadium and all of that. Now the reason I have put this picture here is merging. You know, ultimately what we are talking of is ventilation is there, the stone is, this is a modern house. By no way anybody is going to call it a traditional house, but every material, the walls are hollow walls with air gap to reduce air conditioned loads, the pillars are Dharanidra stones which are load bearing, and the pergolas are precast. So these that you see are not pergolas that are cast out of RCC. I just put this to set off the conversation that is there anything like modern and vernacular ka bada difference kuch hai kya? Ki smart usage of whatever is most creative and most suiting to our project. Is something that we can call it modern. To take the discussion ahead, Maulishree, my question to you would be that 20th century has seen a whole lot of architecture post-independence India. How would you put it? Was it a mix or was it independent style or what?
Okay, not a straight answer, of course. And I'll not even go to post-independence or independence or talk about canons like Korea or Doshi and Stein in Delhi, but just from where I come from, very very immediately, I come from a neighborhood in Delhi jo posh ilaka hai, plotted development hai, bilkul baju mein we have an urban village. So we have what was Taimur Nagar gaon, and then we also have Khijrabad, which very few people know was also where Dara Shikoh was hung several centuries ago, in the village which has no testimony of that anymore. It is by the banks of Yamuna. So if you cross over half a kilometer from my house, you will reach the Yamuna banks, which are now completely built over by what used to be small bastis right behind the SPA hostel, which have now become about 3 to 6 floors of pakka ghar. What I'm trying to get at is today in the current Delhi, which is now probably the 10th layer of Delhi that's being built and rebuilt, we exist in a patchwork. We exist in a small section. If I just do half a kilometer around my house, there will be an urban village. There will be what MCD calls a Jhuggi Jhopri colony. There will be what MCD and the Delhi government calls the UR colony, which is unauthorized, regularized colony. Jo pehle kabhi abadi area, gaon ke abadi area ke bahar khet hote the, usko plotted development karke 25 gaj ke bana ke upar badha diya. We exist in so many different urban typologies which are simultaneously built and they are being developed. To agar aap aadha kilometer andar jayenge gaon mein, wahan log abhi bhi hookka pee rahe hain aur wahan gaay bandhi. But if you move a little bit closer, there are people living off picking garbage from the Yamuna, and they are literally living on heaps of garbage, and they are building their homes from whatever they can gather, most sustainable, right? Everybody in that neighborhood, they walk to work, they cycle to work. I've done long studies with my students when I used to teach in that neighborhood, saying fir smart city kya hoti hai, sab chal ke jaate hain, सब वहीं पे साइकिल करते हैं, आसपास काम करते हैं, घर जो मिलता है लोकल मटेरियल उसी से घर बनाते हैं. व्हाट इज द वर्नैक्युलर, राइट? सो वी, व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस? वेरी वेरी वेल, मॉडर्न पीपल आर बिल्डिंग विद देयर हैंड्स लोकली अवेलेबल मटेरियल्स एंड एग्जिस्टिंग इन द करंट 10th सिटी ऑफ दिल्ली. What are we going to divide this into, a difference of vernacular and modern? This coexistence is everywhere around us. It's within us. It's like trying to separate your past and present. Hum abhi hain, par shayad abhi dimag se peeche kahin purani koi baat soch rahe hain ya 2070 ke plan bana rahe hain. Do we really exist in the present either? We exist in so many domains of time. So ye jo kehna ki ye hum modern versus vernacular is going to be a very hard, and it's a वेल इट्स नॉन प्रोडक्टिव वे ऑफ थिंकिंग अबाउट एनीथिंग. तो हम बड़े सारे टाइम्स में और बड़े सारी जगहों में साइमल्टेनियसली रहते हैं, कभी दिमाग में, कभी बॉडी में, कभी घर में. एंड दैट इज समथिंग विच वी नीड टू इन्वेस्टिगेट हाउ वी कंटिन्यू टू डू दैट ओवर टाइम. सो माई इंटरेस्ट इज इन कंटिन्यूटी
एब्सोल्युटली
वर्सेस एज अपोज टू मेकिंग अ यू नो ड्यूअल आउट ऑफ दिस.
या सो दिस को एग्जिस्टेंस, सबसे बड़ी बात जो आई है दैट इट्स ऑल देयर बट वॉट इज बाइंडिंग इट, इट्स द ह्यूमन फैक्टर दैट जिसको एक ह्यूमन बींग को खुद के कम्फर्ट के लिए वॉट एवर ही नीड्स ही विल डू इट विद इन वॉट एवर मीन्स इज अवेलेबल इन वॉट एवर वे एंड इन अ वेरी क्रिएटिव फैशन. Taking it to the next point, yeah. So I would like to ask you that how you're using some of your, you know, you said that when I, my way of using, connecting vernacular to present time is I recycle a lot of things.
Local material, local labor, local technology, how we are using with perfect ventilation. So I did my project, a new building has to create. Client ne bola saab mereko ek naya building banana hai. तो एक आइडिया आया दिमाग में, कुछ बिल्डिंग्स टूट रही थी जो हेरिटेज बिल्डिंग थी, पुराने झरोखे थे जिसमें पुराने उनके डोर्स वगैरह सब अराउंड 300-400 ईयर्स अगो पुरानी बिल्डिंग्स, इनका इसको वेस्ट नहीं जाना चाहिए, हम इसको यूज़ करेंगे हमारी नई बिल्डिंग के अंदर. उनको एक प्रपोजल दिया, एक स्केच बना के दिखाया, उनको काफ़ी पसंद आया. उस प्रोजेक्ट पर हम लोग अभी वर्क कर रहे हैं, उसमें हम लोगों ने जो ध्यान दिया जो इसके एलिमेंट्स हैं हमारे वर्नाकुलर आर्किटेक्चर जो हम बात करते हैं कि झरोखा वेंटिलेशन के लिए हम लोग जो जाली यूज़ कर रहे हैं या उसमें वरांडा ले रहे हैं या इसके एलिमेंट कोर्टयार्ड, तो उन चीज़ों को ध्यान में रखते हुए हमने इसमें पूरे प्रोजेक्ट को प्रिपेयर किया है और उस पर भी वर्क चल रहा है. दिस ओल्ड झरोखाज आर अराउंड 300 ईयर्स ओल्ड एंड हमने जो लेबर थी वहाँ की उससे बोला कि तो इसको निकालेगा तो वापस लगा देगा कि हाँ सब आप बताओ मैं इसको निकालूंगा, इसके एक एक पार्ट को वापस को रिप्लेस करूँगा. ये सारा पुराना ओल्ड 300 साल पुराना निकाला हुआ झरोखे वगैरह हम लोगों ने नई बिल्डिंग में इसको पेस्ट किया, इसमें कोर्टयार्ड टाइप स्पेस बनाया पूरा, इधर झरोखास वेंटिलेशन है और ये पूरा इसमें आपको जो दिख रहा होगा पूरा कॉरिडोर है जिसको हमने पूरा ओपन रखा है, कोई इसमें सिंगल ग्लास यूज़ नहीं किया है. वेंटिलेशन के लिए हमने ये ओपनिंग्स दी हैं, ये सारी ओपनिंग्स जो हमने दी हैं, ये सारे डोर्स ये सारे ओपनेबल हैं ताकि कोई भी फंक्शन है कोई प्रोग्राम है तो हम डोर्स को ओपन कर सकते हैं. इनफैक्ट ये डोर्स भी सब पुराने हैं जिनको हमने दोबारा रिसाइकल करके इसमें यूज़ किया है. तो वर्नाकुलर पुराने जिनके लेबर हैं जिनको इस काम की नॉलेज है हम उनको उनके काम को कैसे बढ़ा सकते हैं, उनको कैसे अपने साथ में ले सकते हैं हमारी नई टेक्नोलॉजी के अंदर.
सो द पॉइंट इज दिस वर्नाकुलर, इज दिस इंटरप्रिटेशन ऑफ वर्नाकुलर वेयर वी आर टॉकिंग ऑफ एग्जैक्टली आई मीन यूजिंग समथिंग दैट एग्जिस्टेड बिफोर इन अ मॉडर्न डे कॉन्टेक्स्ट एंड एप्लीकेशन ऑफ अ वर्नाकुलर in a modern way. Is this vernacular a question to the audience which we shall debate once I finish one round of discussion? And the next point where we are talking of that when what is vernacular urban mein, do you really think there is a difference or is it the same thing? You know, we are talking of something nothing different, like Maulishri explained. What is your take on it?
Mainly jo vernacular ki jo definition hai wo in short kaha jaye to फॉर द लोकल एंड बाय द लोकल, वो आप किसी भी टर्म्स में ले सकते हैं, आप उसको टेक्निक में ले सकते हैं, आप उसको मटेरियल यूज़ में ले सकते हैं या लोकल नीड के रूप में ले सकते हैं. ज़रूरी नहीं है कि हर सिटी या हर एरिया हर बिल्डिंग या सॉरी हर जोन की नीड अलग हो सकती हैं. तो जैसे जिसकी नीड, जैसा जिसका लोकल मटेरियल अवेलेबल है, जैसे लोकल स्किल लेबर अनस्किल्ड लेबर अवेलेबल है और जैसी टेक्निक अवेलेबल होगी उससे आप जो भी जनरेट कर रहे हैं बाय द लोकल ना फॉर द लोकल, मेरे लिए वो वर्नाकुलर है. अब अपन बात कर रहे हैं कि मॉडर्न टाइम में उसको कैसे हम लोग रिफ्लेक्ट करेंगे. नो डाउट 100% इम्प्लीमेंट आप नहीं कर सकते क्योंकि नीड चेंज हो गई है, कंफर्ट चेंज हो गया है. आज अगर हम बात करें कि मैं एक लेट से जैसलमेर में पटवा हवेली है उसकी कंडीशन में वहीं जाके इतना पुराना टाइम में जैसे बनी थी वहाँ जाके रह पाऊँ तो इट्स इम्पॉसिबल फॉर मी है. आई थिंक सभी के लिए पॉसिबल नहीं होगा क्योंकि वहाँ ना एसी थी ना इलेक्ट्रिसिटी है तो पॉसिबल नहीं था. अब मैं चेंज करेंगे तो नो डाउट वो कम्फर्ट होगा देन वापस बाद नेट जीरो एनर्जी और इन सब पे आ जाएगी. तो इतना पॉसिबल, लेकिन हाँ वी शुड ट्राई, हमें ट्राई करनी चाहिए. मेरा एक प्रोजेक्ट था जिसमें हम लोगों ने क्लाइंट की नीड थी या क्लाइंट का इंटरेस्ट भी था, हम लोगों ने प्रॉपर एक नई बिल्डिंग क्रिएट करी है. उसमें सीमेंट बिल्कुल कम से कम यूज़ करा, हमने लाइम पे बनाई है बिल्डिंग पूरी. नेट जीरो का भी था उसमें. वर्नैक्युलर में क्या था, वर्नैक्युलर जैसे मैं जोधपुर से बिलोंग करता हूँ तो हमारे लिए क्या है, वहाँ पे हॉट एंड ड्राई क्लाइमेट है. ऑब्वियसली हमारे लिए जो वहाँ पे उस पर्टिकुलर टेम्परेचर में सस्टेन करना थोड़ा डिफिकल्ट रहा है. तो ओल्ड सिटी की अगर आपने किसी ने विजिट करा हो तो नैरो स्ट्रीट हैं क्योंकि एक दूसरे का रिफ्लेक्शन की वजह से शेडेड रहता है तो ठंडा रहता है. झरोखाज हैं, एयर वेंटिलेशन मिलता है, फनल इफेक्ट क्रिएट होता है. कोर्टयार्ड कंपलसरी है हमारे लिए क्योंकि एयर मूवमेंट जो हॉट एंड हॉट एयर और कोल्ड एयर का जो ब्रिज का चलता है उसी कंसर्ट लगे हम लोगों ने बनाया. और रेन वाटर का हार्वेस्टिंग का पूरा हमने करा. तो वर्नैक्युलर मेरे लिए है कि आज उस पर्टिकुलर बिल्डिंग को अगर हम देखते हैं तो इंटीरियर देखा जाए तो 100% वर्नैक्युलर है. लेकिन वो अगेन उसमें कहीं रूम्स में एसी यूज़ करा गया है क्योंकि पॉसिबल ही नहीं है कि मैं एक 14x25 feet का रूम बनाऊँ 11 feet हाइट का और उसमें वेंटिलेशन प्रॉपर है लेकिन विदाउट एसी क्लाइंट कम्फर्टेबल नहीं हो पाएगा.
Absolutely.
तो यूज करना ही पड़ेगा.
सो बेसिकली इट्स अबाउट हाउ ह्यूमन बीइंग इन टुडेज कॉन्टेक्स्ट इन टुडेज पैरामीटर कैन बी कंफर्टेबल एंड दैट कैन बी नेम्ड टुडेज मॉडर्न. आई ऐड अ वर्ड टू इट, इट्स नॉट मॉडर्न मॉडर्न, इट्स टुडेज मॉडर्न. एंड देन आई कम टू यू संगीत, दैट व्हाट वुड बी योर अर्बन इंटरप्रिटेशन ऑफ वर्नैक्युलर एंड प्लीज रिफ्रेन फ्रॉम टॉकिंग ऑफ एनीथिंग लोकल. वी हैव हर्ड सो मच ऑफ लोकल कि आई वुड लाइक यू टू टॉक अबाउट इज़म्स. यस.
And that's what I understand actually. Mereko ye sab bhi samajh aata hai. I think the finest example we have just seen Sabina and Rajiv's project. The way they have blended, it's a modern building, but what they have done, they've made a revolution. Wo sara kuch vernacular hi to hai. I mean, vernacular versus or and is the same thing. So we just witnessed a wonderful project by some modernists. And we are both from Chandigarh, we understand that. And when we say Chandigarh is a modern city, ma'am, uspe vernacular kya nahi hai? Hum bricks use karte hain, wahi jute ke darwaze abhi bhi hain. Those four foreigners taught us our own culture. It's called the modern city. What is not vernacular there? Everything it is, everything is natural, and we still do that. I mean, people in Jaipur or Rajasthan may violate, we still don't. It's a law that all the public buildings have to be in brick. Even the concrete, jo cheez aaj hum use karte hain, as you said very rightly, it is modern at that time, and today it's vernacular. Kyunki us zamane ka jo material tha, it was invented. So it's the layers of modernism, layers of vernacular, which stand the test of time. So hum kisi cheez ko old ya new nahi bol sakte. Abhi humne dekha project which is so beautiful and all this project which you have seen. So saying something that this is vernacular aisa nahi hai, as I understand, ma'am, as I understand, because I come from that place where I look at the world with a modern eye, but I know the roots, because the whole thing was a product of the uprootedness. Whole city, modern city is made out of chaos. So wo sab cheezon ko imbibe karte hue ek shahar banaya. So I think modernism, vernacularism, sustainability, they all are same, but inki ek time wrap hai, inke time value hai. This is what I understand, ma'am. Thank you.
I think that's very well put, which I've been talking all the time, that it's just a layer. Us zamane ki jo modern tha has become, that's why I repeatedly use that it is today's modern. So each one's interpretation of modern. So we see another picture on the at the back where we are talking of what is modern. You know, can a railing be modern? And these were made out of nothing. These were made out of nothing but the wastage of the SS factory that the client had. Wastage sheet ko join karke usko banaya. What is modern in it here? It's a jali, no? Us zamane mein bhi triangular jali banti thi. Aaj bhi ye hai. So there is nothing modern. It's just that we guys are blessed with this huge quality of engineering, aesthetics, and proportion. I think these three major factors have been the only constants in this whole genre of building design, whether it was done then or it is being done today. Any building done in the most impressive way, why do we all like the Connaught Place? Just because of the proportion. It makes you feel, wow, so big. Just the proportions. So these are the only three, four constants which architecture has given us. What is happening
टुडे इज विद टुडेज मटेरियल, बट देयर इज अ ह्यूज रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी फैक्टर. हाउ रिस्पॉन्सिबली वी कैन इंटीग्रेट द वैल्यूज ऑफ आर्किटेक्चर विच इन अ मॉडर्न वे फॉर द कम्फर्ट ऑफ ह्यूमन बींग विदाउट स्ट्रेसिंग ऑन एनर्जी, विदाउट स्ट्रेसिंग ऑन द ऑल द अदर यू नो environmental issues. You're not going to cut a hill because you want a palace on top. Rajaon ke zamane mein jab hota tha, there was no concept of sustainability, I would say then, or he did something and against that he made up for it. How did he make up for it? He grew so many trees, he built a lake, he made water. Mandu jab bana tha, we had that time it was very modern because he has recycled the water to make lakes and swimming pools all over for the queens. Purpose may be different, it was a different kind of a expression of his modernity at that period. But today when you are talking of all these are all vernacular and modern, isn't it? So this combo is what we are talking of. Having said that, one more question. In a percentage of a building, how much factor of, again, traditional concept or local material would each one of you use in, and in what way? As a value or as a material? I think that is something which needs to be questioned to each one. What would be the percentage, you know, of usage? So starting with Maulashri, and if you can want to add something, you are most welcome.
No, I don't have an answer to how much percentage, because we are not building in vacuum. We are building as a continuum of human civilization. Hum abhi nahi aaye hain. Humne apne aap nahi sikha hai. Materials humne nahi invent kiye hain. We are learning and we are evolving. I don't think this is a question of breaking it down to some kind of quantification, because like somebody said in the previous session, how long we have been on this earth, you know. So if we see ourselves in that length of time as people who have inhabited a large space, we belong here for a very that inventiveness has been changing, and we are only building it generation to generation. However, I would disagree that there is nothing such as modern, in the sense that there is a very clear style of architecture. You all know about, I mean, we've discussed Chandigarh as modernist, but there's also a quality of being modern, which is to break away from the past in some ways and invent new ways of doing something, whether it's building floors which are expansive or having curtain wall, or building in the 19th or 20th century. So my reference is to modern architecture, with a capital M sometimes if you're talking about high modernism, but also local modernisms. Like we are now just have recently inscribed Shantiniketan on the UNESCO yes. World Heritage List. And Shantiniketan is an experiment in modernity. And by modernity, I mean just as an experiment of doing new things in that time, in the early 1900s, where you're trying to set up an idea of education, an idea of learning, and also an idea of habitat. How can you coexist in the world, in this place away from Calcutta, which was pretty much the center of the world at some point? And how do you do that while Tagore's own experiments of building buildings? So he's got all these wonderful experiments in creating houses and the models. And there's a black mud house called Shyamoli, and there are all these wonderful experiments of trying to establish that we are modern. We have a sense of self and a sense of identity. And that's what's been recognized in the current UNESCO nomination. And we have that kind of modernisms everywhere. We look at Stein's work in Delhi. We look at all these other architects who have developed their own language. I feel that's there's something of value there, which is definitely an experiment of doing something new, that spirit of doing something new. And that has to be recognized, and that has to be celebrated, and that has to be talked about. Otherwise, what's happening today in Delhi is that we are saying, oh, these are useless, these are everywhere, these are such ordinary buildings that we must demolish them. And then what happens to our, you know, COP15 pledges and 2070? We are demolishing these old ministries and these government buildings. The WHO building on ITO has recently been gone, and it had the mural by M.F. Hussain. So many of Habib Rehman's other works, including some prototypes of excellent housings for the government staff, have all gone.
And that and those were our experiments of trying to find new ways of living, because everybody cannot live in a stone house.
Absolutely.
We have to be building for the masses. When you build for the masses, it's impossible to quarry, it's impossible to cut stone. You want to build quickly, you want to build cheaply, you want to maximize your floor area, which is also why you're using glass. And I'm a bit concerned how we've been demonizing glass today a little bit, while it has exceptional qualities which cannot be replicated. So when you're buying a property, you don't want to spend that in 3 feet wide stone walls. You want to maximize floor area. What is happening in Delhi now is that we are breaking all of that. We're saying that's not any inventiveness, that's not any genius on our part in design, because all our genius and sense of place lies in the so-called vernacular. So we must kind of go back and preserve a particular specimen of the past, which is very valuable to us because it appeals to us today. And while we should break down all these other buildings that have actually not lived their life, you're building concrete for at least 100 years, but in 60 years you're saying, yeah, toilets are so smelly, we should bring down all these bhavans in New Delhi and redevelop it. You know, so what happens to sustainability? What happens to recent modern past? The specimens of 19th and 20th century, where we're just beginning to build as a new country, as a newly independent nation trying to find a voice. However fledgling the voice is, we are trying to experiment. And those experiments, including Charles Courier Stadium in Ahmedabad and various other buildings, IIM Ahmedabad's early, the dormitories that are under threat, all of those represent a certain mode of thinking. And if we don't respect that, we're going to be constantly stuck in this debate of past versus present and Haveli versus glass. That's not the point at all. That just helps us speed up the demolition of everything we have, while actually all that we have is the greenest building today. We need to be able to conserve more. So this is a kind of a trap. We need to free ourselves, and we need to think about all kinds of past, including recent past, for all kinds of people, including ordinary people. Small single room houses are also specimens worth preserving and worth building upon. But we are only trying to preserve kingdoms and palaces and havelis, exactly. Right? We need to be able to break that.
Absolutely.
And we need to be able to be much more inclusive because of the diversity that Parum Ram's been talking about. We are such a rich country. So I think there is something here to talk about many times and many places, which are all valuable, and we need to find a way to continue that intelligence.
I agree fully, and thank you for bringing up this beautiful point, the continuity. How do you establish the continuity of architecture? Unfortunately, in India, we have never said any ism. See, the world had all kinds of names. Bauhaus architecture, we have got, the Baroque architecture, we have got all kinds. India, as usual, we never believed in documentation, we never believed in formalizing, always everything was very, very informal, and therefore we never gave names. So, as she rightly pointed out, all these beautiful housing colonies which were talking of ways of mass living from the villages to the cities, never got any recognition, because they were all Indian architects. Coming back to the stadium, for which I am fighting a lot these days, it was a folded plate stadium with a capacity of 40,000 seating, built in 1963 to 66 by Charles Courier and Mahendra Raj with his columnists. How many stadiums have we seen in India which is modern, so-called, quote-unquote, and that has no columns? And it looks like a flower when you see it from the top. And that stadium, they thought that it is not worth it. It is worth a demolition. And we are fighting for it. Can we not make it inclusive? There are 800 trees. That's a fantastic example. Recently, they have decided, okay, you go and get the money and we will restore it. So look at where we architects have reached in our position. If I want to restore, mere ko jaake paisa lana hai, wo project ke liye, and mere ko karna hai, aapko 3 mahina diya ja raha hai, please get the money and restore it. Give us the money, we'll restore it. So that's the way level we are. Why? Because nobody else has listed these buildings. There is no notification saying that these are our post-independence Indian architecture which needs a conservation, which needs to be which needs to show our map of India, how it has grown over the years,
So that is where I think this question is very important. From which level the variety we have achieved till today, you know, through our own indigenous methods of using a material, you know, which country has got 6-inch slabs? Entire RCC all over the world, what are beams? We have done some multinational projects. What are beams? We don't believe in beams. Just create an 8-inch slab. We are so sustainable. Our structural engineers always talk of 6-inch of slab and beams, and architects are there to guide the structural engineer, marry together the two indigenous technology, architecture, which is a more on aesthetics, and engineering together to make sure that the building is cost effective. That kind of effort, if our architects have made over so many years, I think it becomes our responsibility to all the students of Mohanlal Sukaria University, the new 1-year-old architecture student, 2-year-old architecture students, to understand this and to be able to, you know, take it forward in a very judicious way.
आपने जो पहले पूछा था कि कितना परसेंटेज आप यूज़ करेंगे, जैसा मैंने पहले बोला कि वर्नेकुलर सिर्फ एक मटेरियल बेस्ड नहीं कहलाएगा, प्लानिंग कंसेप्ट, लोकल आर्टिजन्स कितने यूज़ हो रहे हैं उसमें, लोकल मटेरियल कितना, प्लानिंग में कितना ध्यान दिया, कंसेप्ट क्या है, टेक्नोलॉजी क्या है, उस पर रहता है. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, मैं जिस बिल्डिंग में रह रहा हूँ वो बहुत वेल प्लान्ड है, अपार्टमेंट है, बीच में एक अच्छा सा कोर्टयार्ड है, उसके अलावा उसमें कुछ भी वर्नेकुलर नहीं है. मटेरियल की बात करें कुछ भी नहीं है, टेक्निक कुछ भी नहीं है, टिपिकल आरसीसी स्ट्रक्चर है वो, लेकिन उसकी प्लानिंग इतनी अच्छे से है जिसमें प्रॉपर डे टाइम पूरे फ्लैट के किसी भी कोने में आर्टिफिशियल लाइट की जरूरत नहीं पड़ती हमें, फुल टाइम डे. अच्छा, वेंटिलेशन इतना है, मैं लास्ट 4 ईयर्स उस बिल्डिंग में रह रहा हूँ एंड आई रिमेंबर मैंने 12 मंथ्स में हार्डली 20-25 डेज एसी ऑन करा होगा, इतना कंफर्ट है. यूज़ भी करते हैं तो रात को बंद करना पड़ता है, तो वो लाइट वेंटिलेशन चाहिए, वो वेल प्लान्ड है, ठीक है. लेकिन उसमें अब मटेरियल की बात करेंगे कुछ भी नहीं उसमें,
ठीक है. इट्स नॉट अबाउट मटेरियल, इट्स अबाउट द कंफर्ट.
तो मैं परसेंटेज की बात इसलिए नहीं कर सकते क्योंकि डिपेंड्स अपन प्रोजेक्ट क्या है, प्रोजेक्ट कैसा प्रोजेक्ट है, उस पर डिपेंड करेगा.
हम अपने सारे प्रोजेक्ट्स को तो नहीं कर सकते, पर कुछ ऐसे प्रोजेक्ट्स जो छोटे हैं, फार्म हाउसेज हैं, तो हम इनको इको फ्रेंडली बना सकते हैं. इको फ्रेंडली मीन्स हम इसमें मड ब्लॉक्स भी यूज़ कर सकते हैं, है ना. तो मड फ्लोर है अपना, वुडन फ्लोर है, फ्लोर पे भी आप मड यूज़ कर सकते हैं, सीमेंट फ्लोर यूज़ कर सकते हैं. तो टाइल से जो आपका जो कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड आ रहा है, कर रहा है, तो वो काफ़ी हद तक रुक सकता है. तो हम, मेरा मानना है कि 40%, 50% भी अगर इस तरह से कंस्ट्रक्शन यूज़ कर लें तो काफ़ी बेटर हो जाएगा.
It's always there. 40% you can always make it more, you know, vernacular principles or material or something. But and okay. I'll talk about it later. And you?
100% modernism, 100% vernacular. That makes it 200% architecture. That's it.
That's a nice answer. Yeah, and that I think will be very interesting in seeing. You know, the door that we have done, that's marble jali, handmade. Okay, we could have used etched glass, we could have used something, but as we have always been talking in Abhikram, kuch to art aur kuch to unique karo, the client has money. Why not give it to the craftsman who can do beautiful marble jali? The door was wanted to be heavy. So what we have done is, in a very modern house, the door jali, that's how it looks from inside and this is how it looks from outside, that's a hand cut, purely vernacular technique used, no laser cutting, just because the impact was good. Now, these are small funny things I have put in between. So a question that becomes very, very relevant in connecting with the teaching is, you know, when Shantiniketan was built, I'm talking of pre-independence, Rabindranath Tagore was very, very lucky to have a rich father. But when he built this, he used to actually make paintings because his brother was an ICS in Ahmedabad, Gujarat. He used to come to Ahmedabad, make paintings, sell them to the rich mill owners, use the money for Shantiniketan, number one. Number two, Shantiniketan was a concept of education. I think that is very important, and all of us architects are supposed to come up with a concept which is unique, which is a marriage of modern and vernacular. And the concept was that you're not studying only textbooks. Children cannot be taught things just like that. They need to be, which is so modern, isn't it? Today we are talking of us zamane ka education system as a modern system. There is nothing like vernacular. It's a coexistence. It's a unified policy. And the most important thing, as I always say, it's the responsibility with which We can convince a client. I think that never came up in any of our dialogues, that you are a leader. We are not just creative people. We have to have the way of strategizing to convince a client how not to use too much of glass, how we can include a modern thing. And that becomes, I think, our major agenda for today. These are some examples, again, those fun examples where I could have used glass as a thing, but we have bent the glass and used all kinds of crazy things. As this goes on at the back, which is a modern house using the vernacular technology, the floor is open to questions.
Like, vernacular term is related with indigenous, native and rural. So there is not any similarity with vernacular or modern. In fact, vernacular is vernacular, and if we use those traditional elements in modern architecture, then we can say interpretation or influence of vernacular architecture in modern architecture. So by using traditional element, modern cannot be called as vernacular.
What is traditional in this?
No, this is completely modern architecture. Only the influence of vernacular architecture can be seen here.
Right.
Otherwise, it's a modern architecture. We can use any element in modern building.
The answer is
vernacular is always related with the rural and
not necessarily. Buildings
by people for the people and indigenous.
No, I think this is something. Why this stone was used? Because this house is in Bangalore. Sadar Ali is the local stone there, and that is why those pillars were used, which is absolutely vernacular there. So context and the location and what is vernacular there. So it's very, very important.
Some of us at least have interpreted this vernacular as just traditional. I think that's what organizers meant to say. In vernacular is very much indigenous heritage, which is not what we are actually talking about. My language, I would say more local. Some of us have used traditional, and then there might be elements of vernacular in some people's work. But the idea here was to present, I think we have broadly interpreted it more as modern versus traditional, because the question of vernacular and modern being the same doesn't arise. That's why we are trying to find a bridge or a word that connects the two instead of making this opposition. So you're right, indigenous is not the right word, I think, in this discussion. It's just this modern versus traditional.
With this, one hands up, that all of us are going to do something that our client would like to do. Okay, our client wants, but we are going to be responsible enough to interpret it, which will be a responsible solution, which could be modern, it could be minimalistic, which is the trend of today, which was the trend earlier also. Suddenly in between we started crowding our houses or the buildings. So minimalistic, modern, and something which is very, very relevant for today's lifestyle.
जैसा कि मैम ने बोला कि रूलर, रूलर में ही थोड़ी होगा वर्नाकुलर, अर्बन में भी, लाइक उदयपुर, यहाँ पे भी लोकल मटेरियल है, तो व्हाई नॉट हियर इन वर्नाकुलर, यहाँ क्यों नहीं हो सकता है? लाइक हम दो चीजों की बात करते हैं हमेशा, ट्रेडिशनल आर्किटेक्चर एंड वर्नाकुलर आर्किटेक्चर, बोथ आर द डिफरेंट. ट्रेडिशनल आर्किटेक्चर हैज सम वैल्यूज, मतलब ओल्ड वैल्यूज, बेसिकली पारंपरिक चीजें जो हम सदियों से लेते आए हैं, ठीक है. एंड वर्नाकुलर, जस्ट आज भी मेरे को कोई मटेरियल मिला, मैंने उससे कुछ बना दिया, दैट इज वर्नाकुलर आर्किटेक्चर. नो मैडम,
आई थिंक देयर इज अ कंफ्यूजन.
नो, वर्नाकुलर, लाइक सपोज करिए कि मेरे को उदयपुर में कुछ दूसरा मटेरियल मिलता है, लाइक ग्रेनाइट, यहाँ पे लोकल मटेरियल मिल जाता है, अगर मैं उससे कुछ बना रहा हूँ, यहाँ के लोग बना रहे हैं, तो दैट इज वर्नाकुलर ना. लोकल मटेरियल फॉर बाय लोकल पीपल फॉर लोकल पीपल.
Yes, it's just that the technique that
but
you
traditional
use.
Architecture is old values. कि आपने कुछ बनाया जैसे like मंदिर में ही वो चीज होनी चाहिए, तो वो refineness आ रही है. Traditional architecture में आपको refineness आती है, उसके लिए skilled person चाहिए traditional architecture के लिए, लेकिन vernacular architecture के लिए आपको skilled person नहीं चाहिए.
Skill is a very widely explained term. मठ घर बनाने का, सो वॉट एवर स्किल, दैट्स व्हाई आई फर्स्ट ओपनिंग स्टेटमेंट वाज, इट इज अ लेयर ऑफ अ टेक्नोलॉजी बीइंग यूज्ड दैट इज अवेलेबल एट दैट पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम. सो मठ टेक्नोलॉजी इज अ स्किल. मठ हाउसेस आर वेरी ब्यूटिफुल. No, why vernacular? Why do you want to give a name to it? It is not mud architecture in today. When you go to, why all of you go to Auroville? Because you all want to learn vernacular architecture because so and so is staying there. Why do you want to go? Yeah, why? Everybody wants to go to Auroville. What is not modern about it? Everything is modern, isn't it? So mud is only a material. The application and usage is modern or not. That is what
मैं मॉडर्न की बात ही नहीं कर रहा, मैं ट्रेडिशनल आर्किटेक्चर एंड वर्नाकुलर आर्किटेक्चर की बात कर रहा
हूं. You are talking of ornamentation.
Yes.
Ornamentation and a particular building has a particular use. मंदिर है तो ईस्ट दिशा में भगवान की मुंह होनी चाहिए, उसके पीछे there has to be a घुंबट, दरवाजे पे कार्विंग एंड ऑल दैट आर decorations.
हां, बट दैट इज नॉट वर्नाकुलर.
No, it's carving.
It's traditional.
No, it's not ready. It's skill.
Yes, skilled.
Yeah.